After surviving their planned lifespan by 9 times, the Voyagers are basically pronounced dead. Responsible for more space exploration firsts and records than any other space probe, the Voyager twins undoubtedly make their mark in human history. From their birth to interstellar grave, let's remember humanity's farthest journey so far. Launched by NASA, the world's most renowned space agency, on the 20th of August 1977, Voyager 2 became one of humanity's most trusted and sophisticated space probe machines. Just like its twin Voyager 1 that's being launched 16 days later on the 5th of September the same year. The time of their start was carefully planned as the probes had to take advantage of a special alignment of outer planets that happens every 176 years on average. This way, a gravity assist maneuver, aka a gravity slingshot, could be utilized, meaning that the spacecraft's travel time to Neptune could be reduced from 30 years to 12. Originally, the mission was named Mariner Jupiter Saturn 1977, or MJS 1977, and the plan was to send out 5 probes instead of 2, but due to some financial constraints, the US Congress cut down on the budget. At launch, both spacecrafts were about the size of a subcompact car and weighed 1,797 pounds, or 815 kilograms. The boom for the Voyager's magnetometer instrument extends 42.7 feet or 13 meters, giving the instruments a unique look most people recognize. Despite being the last one to take off, Voyager 1 traveled a shorter path, allowing it to sail past its brother in December 1977. Since then, both spacecrafts have gone on to reveal the most hidden secrets about our universe. To facilitate their space exploration efforts, NASA engineers equipped them with 11 sophisticated instruments, including an imaging science system, ultraviolet spectrometer, infrared interferometer spectrometer, planetary radio astrometer equipment, and many more. Engineering excellence was much needed for the powering of the two Voyagers, as solar energy wasn't an option for them to operate on, especially because they were expected to travel at least 778 million miles away from the Sun. Hence, the designers opted to power them with nuclear energy. Additionally, each Voyager spacecraft also carries a vintage golden disc containing pre-recorded messages from high-ranking former US politicians and United Nations officials, as well as pictures and videos of different life elements on Earth, including images of dolphins, sunsets, dances, and 90 minutes of music. If any of the Voyager spacecraft is intercepted by another civilization, the content of this disc will help convey our message of peace to them. The selection was made by the world-famous astronomer Carl Sagan and often regarded as his legacy. In March 1979, and around 265 million kilometers away from Earth and 2 years in the mission, Voyager 1 arrived at Jupiter, and over the next 1 month, it sent back 19,000 pictures of the largest planet in our solar system. This includes completing a mind-blowing 100-hour session of capturing Jupiter's rotation. During this session, Voyager 1 captured 3,750 pictures, which were eventually compiled to make a time-lapse movie to showcase 10 rotations of the planet. It was the first time ever humanity detected lightning on a planet other than Earth, just like the discovery of nitrogen-rich atmosphere, which also remains a humanity's first. The Voyager 2 arrived just on time at Jupiter to continue from where Voyager 1 left off. And over the course of the next 4 months, between April and August, the Voyager 2 spacecraft would send us even more pictures. Altogether, both spacecraft captured 33,000 pictures of Jupiter and its 5 major satellites. Apart from the incredible science data mentioned so far, some of the most iconic elements revealed by Voyager 1 and Voyager 2 during the exploration of Jupiter include the discovery of Thebe and Matisse moon, as well as a thin ring around the planet. They also found evidence of an ocean beneath one of Jupiter's moons, Europa. However, Voyager's biggest discovery around Jupiter remains the volcanic activity it captured around the surface of Io, one of the gas giant's moons. prior to that discovery, the only active volcanoes we knew about were the ones on Earth. Between 1980 and 1981, the Voyager spacecraft proceeded to Saturn to continue their journey deep into space. And during their exploration of Saturn, they revealed deep insights about the planet's ring structure, atmosphere and moons, including Mimas, Enceladus, Tethys, Dione and Rhea. From then on, the two spacecrafts went their separate ways. Voyager 1 headed for the corridors of our solar system, while the Voyager 2 continued to explore the solar system. The next stop for Voyager 2 was Uranus and Neptune. The spacecraft came within 50,600 miles of Uranus in January 1986, capturing images of 10 new moons and 2 new rings. 2 years later, it approached Neptune as close as 3,000 miles, revealing another 5 moons, 4 rings, and the Great Dark Spot. Till date, the Voyager 2 remains the only spacecraft to explore all 4 giant planets in our solar system. After billions of miles of travelling and 67,000 iconic images, the grand tour of both spacecraft around our solar system was completed. Consequently, the cameras of the Voyager 1 was turned off to save energy and extend its life. However, there was one exception, as on February 14, 1990, the probe's eyes were turned on once more to look back and take a photo of the solar system from a distance of 3.7 billion miles. Known as the Solar System Family Portrait and showing Earth as nothing more than a pale blue dot in the never-ending cosmic vastness. On the 25th of August 2012, history was made as the Voyager 1 became the first man-made object to cross the corridors of our solar system into the interplanetary world. On December 18, 2018, the Voyager 2 joined its twin in interstellar space. Despite being extensively protected against radiation, which also set the standard for radiation design margins still in use for space missions today, and equipped with autonomous fault protection, the probes have seen better days. According to reports, the power levels of both spacecraft have significantly dropped in the last couple of years. Normally, the operational lifespan of both Voyager spacecraft was estimated to cover only the grand tour of our solar system, which was supposed to last between 4 to 5 years. Currently, only 5 of Voyager 2 equipment are functional, and only 4 of Voyager 1's equipment are active. But they are functioning on a very low level, meaning that the instruments are more likely in a standby mode. However, it's clear that the mission is approaching its final phase and the days of the probes are numbered. Engineers do their best to prolong their journey. To further preserve energy, NASA has switched off the heater for the cosmic ray detector, but the performance level continues to drop as it travels further into the uncharted territories outside our solar system. Nowadays, a one-way message to the Voyager 2 takes 18 hours to deliver and about 22 hours to reach the Voyager 1. Being at 12 and 14.5 billion miles from their home in the never-ending loneliness, every single day with data provided by them is a blessing. No matter which will be their very last day, the images they've sent back to us will remain in our memory forever.